When the Lord gave that word, he said, Kadosh yourself to me. The next part of that is, for tomorrow I'll do wonders among you. Now those wonders were vast, a number of wonders, but they were all impossibilities. And I feel like the Lord's saying, separate yourself to me, because I'm about to handle some impossible situations for you. I don't want to hype that up in any way. Just tell you, this is what I feel the Lord saying. That Kadosh yourself to me is an announcement that there's a season that he's going to move you into, that you're going to need to have had a forerunning season of separating yourself to him. So we're going to take this as an assignment that we've stepped into tonight, not just a moment in a meeting on a Friday night. I believe this is what God is saying to us. I'm about to light it up with a group of people who are not moved by degrees of darkness. And in order to prophetically announce that to you, I'm starting with this word, separate yourself to me. I grew up in the Pentecostal world, therefore, anytime we heard the idea of consecration, it meant get away from dirty stuff. Never at any point in time was I ever taught that it had to do with union. And the truth is it has everything to do with union. There's another word, Dutch teaches on this, there's another word for get away from the bad stuff, that's nazir or nazir, but that's not the word he uses here. He doesn't say, you know, that we would connect that to a Nazirite vow. Don't touch anything dead. Don't let a razor come to your head. Don't have any strong drink. That's not what he's saying to them. He's saying to them, let's you and I go into a time together that's an announcement that I'm about to deal with some impossible situations. Kadosh yourself to me, for tomorrow I'll do wonders among you.